I do think an important point is related to the WHO describing this infection as a pandemic. The WHO is responsible for considering the health of the entire world. And so for them, they are looking at parameters related to how many countries are involved, how quickly is the virus spreading, and what impact is that having on the global community. The last pandemic we had was H1N1 back in 2009. So this coronavirus is now designated as a pandemic. That does not change anything about our current experience in Iowa about coronavirus. So public health agencies have said the most important thing is to consider your local factors with this virus and how is it spreading and acting within your local community. So I think people are familiar with the notion of a pandemic, and yes, this is a pandemic virus, and for now we do not have any community spread in Iowa. But if that changes over time, then our response to that will change. I think it is perfectly normal to worry in a situation like this. There's a lot of uncertainty. There's uncertainty in healthcare providers. There's uncertainty in the community. There's uncertainty in community leadership and government. What is the best way forward? And I think if we can continue to work together and remember that we're all in this together, I think we're all gonna do a lot better sticking together. I think I am so grateful for the role of public health helping guide us in terms of when and how do we change our approach. And we continue to work with public health, with our local hospitals, with our local nursing homes, with our local government regularly as this is unfolding to try and hit that best response possible based on the situation that we're seeing, while we are also preparing for the potential for what if this were to get worse over time. So all of that planning is in process, and I think we'll see where it goes. The thing about preventative medicine is you often don't know for sure if it worked or not. If you get a vaccine and you don't get the virus that the vaccine was for, well, maybe it helped. So, you know, we're doing all of these interventions of social distancing and preparation in order to try and prevent this virus from being severe. And God willing, it will not be severe. And then we'll say, great, it worked. And we might say, why did we do all of that work to prevent something that didn't end up happening? I do think that our efforts are worth it. I think all of the disruption of canceling different things, I think as that comes forward, if we can prevent this infection from spreading beyond our capacity to care for it, it will be a major benefit for our community, especially the people that are most vulnerable. Don't forget that, you know, healthcare providers are on the front lines, and they're choosing every day to show up and care for patients and keep caring for them, even in the face of this virus. And, you know, I'm just so appreciative of all the healthcare providers throughout the community that have stepped up and continued to come to work every day ready to do whatever needs to be done.